Hey guys, welcome back again. I hope you all are doing great. Friend, this video is going to be about the IELTS writing task 2. That's going to be the essay. I'm going to talk about different categories and I'll be discussing essay about them. So, aisa nahi hai ki sirf academic hai ya ye sirf general ki task hai. This can happen in both, this can come in both. So, both have equal importance. I've recently posted a video on task 1 for general candidates that are letters. You can check out that. If anyone is still facing some trouble figuring out the answers, please write me down in the comment section and I will reply them to you. So let's not waste time and move to the task 2. Let's see it. Alright, the first category is going to be about children. जिन लोगों ने अगर आप लोग फॉलो करते हैं तो अब तक आप देख चुके होंगे कि जनवरी के अंदर चिल्ड्रन से रिलेटेड क्वेश्चंस पूछे जा चुके हैं. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सम पीपल बिलीव दैट ऑनलाइन रीडिंग मटेरियल्स शुड ओनली बी यूज्ड फॉर अ चाइल्ड टू लर्न टू रीड, वेयर एज अदर्स बिलीव ओनली प्रिंटेड मटेरियल्स शुड बी यूज्ड. डिस्कस बोथ व्यूज एंड गिव योर ओपिनियन. ऑलराइट, क्वेश्चन कह रहा है कि बच्चों को पढ़ाने के लिए जो ऑनलाइन रीडिंग मटेरियल होता है वही यूज़ करना चाहिए, लेकिन कुछ लोग ये कहते हैं कि जो मटेरियल हमारे पास प्रिंटेड फॉर्म में हो हमें वो यूज़ करना चाहिए. डिस्कस बोथ व्यूज एंड गिव योर ओपिनियन. आपको दोनों साइड्स के बारे में डिस्कस करना है और अपना व्यू पॉइंट बताना है. कुछ लोग मानते हैं कि ऑनलाइन रीडिंग मटेरियल जो होता है वहाँ से पढ़ के बच्चे समझते हैं. कई लोगों का ये मानना है कि प्रिंटेड फॉर्म मच मच बेटर चीज़ है, क्योंकि यू कैन एक्चुअली हैव इट इन योर हैंड, यू कैन फील इट, यू कैन सी इट, एंड पिक्चराइजेशन से हमेशा विजुअल से आप जल्दी समझ पाते हो. Second question, some children find subjects, example mathematics and philosophy, difficult and these subjects should be optional instead of compulsory. To what extent do you agree? Alright, कई बच्चों को कुछ subjects का phobia होता है, like काफ़ी सारे लोगों को maths का होता है. So यहाँ पर examiner यही बात कर रहा है. वो कह रहा है कि कई लोगों का मानना है कि कुछ subjects difficult होते हैं, जैसे कि maths and say like philosophy. तो वो मानने कि इनको मेन ना, इनको कंपलसरी ना किया जाए बल्कि ऑप्शनल रखा जाए. आपको बताना कि आप किस हद तक सहमत हो इस चीज़ से. राइट, प्लीज़ मेक श्योर कि जब भी ऐसी कोई चीज़ आए आप अपने एग्जांपल्स ज़रूर दें. एग्जांपल्स आर लाइक द सोल ऑफ योर एसे. नेक्स्ट, दिस डेज चिल्ड्रन विटनेस अ लॉट ऑफ वायलेंस इन कंप्यूटर गेम्स, टीवी, मूवीज एटसेट्रा. डज इट हैव एनी हार्मफुल इम्पैक्ट्स ऑन देम? हाउ कैन दिस प्रॉब्लम बी रिजॉल्व? ये क्वेश्चन पहले भी बहुत बार आया है. इट्स नॉट दैट केस ओनली 2019, 2018, 17. यू कैन सी दिस क्वेश्चन, यू कैन ट्रेस इट बैक डाउन टू मेनी ईयर्स. क्वेश्चन है कि कंप्यूटर गेम्स के अंदर, टीवी के अंदर आजकल बहुत ज़्यादा वॉलेंस दिखाया जाता है एंड इसका बच्चों के ऊपर प्रभाव पड़ता है. इट डेफिनेटली हैज इम्पैक्ट ऑन द किड्स. बट ये आपको बताना है कि इसको कैसे रिजॉल्व किया जा सकता है. एग्जाम्पल यही आपसे पूछ रहा है. यू टू मेंशन, यू नीड टू गिव एग्जाम्पल्स योर टेक्निक्स. प्लीज़ मेक श्योर कि आप दो तीन टेक्निक्स के बारे में ज़रूर बात करें. लाइक कई बार ऐसा होता है कि हम टीवी चैनल्स पे चाइल्ड रिमोट लॉक लगा सकते हैं और वी कैन बैन फ्यू चैनल्स. हम कुछ चैनल को सब्सक्राइब भी ना करें, जैसे एक्शन मूवीज़ वगैरह जिस पर दिखाई जाती हैं. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, चिल्ड्रन नाउडेज स्पेंड अ ग्रेट डील ऑफ टाइम वॉचिंग टेलीविजन. हाउएवर, टेलीविजन कैन नॉट रिप्लेस द बुक एज अ लर्निंग टूल. Which is why children are less well educated today. To what extent do you agree with this statement? This is a very beautiful question. Question कह रहा है कि आजकल कई बच्चे अपना बहुत सारा समय टीवी देखते हुए निकाल देते हैं. और question कह रहा है कि टेलीविजन जो है वो कभी भी एक बुक को रिप्लेस नहीं कर सकता. इसलिए आजकल के जो बच्चे हैं वो एजुकेटेड तो हैं पर लेस वेल एजुकेटेड है. इसका मतलब ये है दे आर लेस वेल इन्फॉर्म्ड. यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस सेंटेंसेस वेरी केयरफुली. To what extent do you agree with this statement? आपको बताना है कि आप इस स्टेटमेंट से किस हद तक सहमत हैं कि टेलीविजन जो है वो कभी भी एक बुक का काम नहीं कर सकता. Alright, some people think parents should supervise their children's activities closely while others believe children should have more freedom. कुछ लोग का मानना ये है कि पेरेंट्स को अपने बच्चों पे ध्यान रखना चाहिए, उनकी एक्टिविटीज़ पर नज़र रखना चाहिए, क्या कर रहे हैं, कहाँ जा रहे हैं, क्या देख रहे हैं टीवी पे, सोशल मीडिया पे क्या यूज़ कर रहे हैं. और कई लोगों का मानना है कि पेरेंट्स को अपने बच्चों को ज़्यादा फ्रीडम देनी चाहिए. आपको दोनों साइड डिस्कस करनी है. यू नीड टू डिस्कस बोथ द साइड्स एंड यू नीड टू मेंशन योर व्यू पॉइंट्स अकॉर्डिंगली. नेक्स्ट, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट टेक्नोलॉजी. टेक्नोलॉजी, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सम पीपल से दैट मॉडर्न इनोवेशंस ब्रिंग अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स देन बेनिफिट्स. यू एग्री और डिसएग्री? कि आजकल जो मॉडर्न इनोवेशंस हो रही हैं, नई नई टेक्नोलॉजीज आ रही है, उससे फ़ायदे से ज़्यादा नुकसान आते हैं. या आपको बताना है कि क्या आप इस बात से सहमत हैं या नहीं है. ऑलराइट, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, Since most information about culture and history can be found on the internet, museums are not needed anymore. To what extent do we agree? All right. ये क्वेश्चन हिस्ट्री पार्ट से भी है एंड दिस इज ऑन मॉडर्न इन्फॉर्मेशन. ओके, क्वेश्चन कह रहा है कि आजकल बहुत सारी जो इन्फॉर्मेशन आर रिलेटेड टू कल्चर एंड हिस्ट्री कैन बी फाउंड ऑन द इंटरनेट, लाइक इंटरनेट इज अ बिग इंसाइक्लोपीडिया. तो क्या हमें म्यूजियम की सच में जरूरत है या नहीं है? आपको ये बताना आप इस पे किस हद तक सहमत. अगर आप कहते हैं कि बिल्कुल हमें म्यूजियम की जरूरत है तो क्यों है, और नहीं है तो क्यों नहीं. मैनी फील दैट टेक्नोलॉजी टूडे इज इंक्रीजिंग द डिवाइड बिटवीन वेल्दी एंड पुअर. To what extent do you agree or disagree? Nice question. Question is saying कि आजकल जो अमीर और गरीब का फर्क है टेक्नोलॉजी की वजह से और ज़्यादा वाइडन अप होता जा रहा है. मैनी फील दैट टेक्नोलॉजी टूडे इज इंक्रीजिंग द डिवाइड. डिवाइड मीन्स डिविजन, पार्टीशन. बेसिकली द गैप इज इंक्रीजिंग बिटवीन द रिच एंड द पुअर एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग इन टू इट अलॉट. यू नीड टू एक्सप्लेन आप टू वट एक्सटेंट डू यू एग्री, आप किस तक सहमत है. लाइक देर आर मेनी रीजन्स टू इट. वेल्दी पीपल यूज लाइक टेक्नोलॉजी. They can afford a lot of technology, right? So they use it, and poor people are actually deprived of those basic things like food, shelter. So they can rarely think of any kind of technology. Earlier developments in technology brought more benefits to change the lives of ordinary people than recent ones do. Do you agree or disagree? Very nice question. Question is saying कि पहले जो inventions हुए थे उसने आम आदमी की जिंदगी बहुत ज़्यादा बदला और बहुत benefits दिए. Like for example, टेलीफोन जब बना, और से लाइक कम्युनिकेशन मैन स्टार्टेड, यू कैन टॉक अबाउट द कार जब बनी थी. तो लेकिन आजकल की जो इन्वेंशंस हैं वो हमें नुकसान ज़्यादा पहुंचा रही है, राइट. दे डोंट हैव दैट मच काइंड ऑफ बेनिफिट्स. यू नीड टू एक्सप्लेन. दिस डेज मैनी पीपल हैव देयर ओन कंप्यूटर एंड टेलीफोन, सो इट इज़ क्वाइट ईजी फॉर देम टू डू देयर जॉब एट होम. डज वर्किंग एट होम हैव मोर एडवांटेजेस मोर डिसएडवांटेजेस. ये क्वेश्चन इस टेन्योर के अंदर आया है एंड आई विल से इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट considering this session of Jan and say like January 2020. Question कह रहे हैं आजकल लोगों के पास अपने computers हैं, अपने mobile phones हैं, they are having a very quick access to internet and they prefer working from home. A lot of people do. So you need to tell working from home has got more advantages or it has got more disadvantages. कि घर पर आप काम करते हो अपनी freedom रहती है, but then आप socially deprived रहते हो, you don't get to meet a lot of people, you don't get to learn those things. इमोशनली आप डिप्राइव रहते हो, बट देन यू हैव द फ्रीडम टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स इन योर स्पेयर टाइम. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट गवर्नमेंट. गवर्नमेंट कैटेगरी हमेशा से इंपॉर्टेंट रही है, राइट. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इन मेनी कंट्रीज द गवर्नमेंट लाइक्स टू स्पेंड मोर मनी ऑन आर्ट्स. सम पीपल एग्री, हाउएवर सम पीपल थिंक गवर्नमेंट शुड स्पेंड मोर ऑन हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन. कई देश की जो सरकार है वो काफी ज्यादा पैसा खर्च करती है आर्ट्स के ऊपर, पर कुछ लोगों का मानना है कि गवर्नमेंट को वो पैसे हेल्थ और एजुकेशन के ऊपर खर्च करने चाहिए. वे जो कई हद तक सहमत भी है, कई नहीं भी. पीपल हैव देयर ओन व्यू पॉइंट. सो सम पीपल फील टू से दैट गवर्नमेंट एक्चुअली वॉन्ट्स टू से द हिस्ट्री. हिस्ट्री इज अवर ट्रेजर. हाउ डिड वी केम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस एंड ऑल. बट सम पीपल बिलीव वी नीड टू लिव इन द प्रेजेंट मोमेंट एंड वी नीड टू टैकल द प्रॉब्लम्स वी आर फेसिंग राइट नाउ. सो आंसर अकॉर्डिंगली. नेक्स्ट, scientific research should be funded by governments rather than commercial organizations. To what extent do you agree or disagree? All right, this is scientific research is of utmost importance. Aapko like abhi recently there's so many viruses that are going around and scientific research se hame kafi cheezon ka solution milta, right. So aisa nahi hai ki koi medicine hai humne directly bana li. There's a lot of research going on in the back end which is funded by commercial organizations, which means private organization. So people wants to say that कि ये जो रिसर्च है, राइट, साइंटिफिक रिसर्च है, ये गवर्नमेंट को सपोर्ट करनी चाहिए, ना कि कमर्शियल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को. आपको बताना आप किस हद तक सहमत है. डू यू टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट डू यू एग्री और डिसएग्री. नेक्स्ट, सम बिलीव दैट इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ पीपल टू टेक केयर ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट. अदर से इट इज द गवर्नमेंट दैट शुड टेक केयर ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट. डिस्कस. इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, राइट. वैसे आई फील इट कैन कम इन बोथ कैटेगरी ऑफ एनवायरमेंट एज वेल एज गवर्नमेंट. तो कुछ लोग का ये मानना है कि ये सरकार की जिम्मेदारी बनती है. इट इज़ द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी गवर्नमेंट टू टेक केयर ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट, राइट. पर्यावरण हमारे लिए बहुत ज़्यादा जरूरी है, जो आजकल हर जगह इट इज़ बीइंग हैम्पर्ड बैडली. वेयर सम पीपल बिलीव इट इज़ द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल्स टू टेक केयर ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट. यू नीड टू मैंशन इंडिया एग्जाम ने जस्ट लिखा डिस्कस. सो यू आर फ्री टू डिस्कस बोथ द साइड. मेक श्योर यू गिव योर ओपिनियंस अबाउट इट. Should education and healthcare be free of charge and funded by the government, or should it be responsible to the people to pay for the services? All right. कि जो एजुकेशन हमें मिलती है या जो हेल्थ केयर फैसिलिटीज हम अवेल करते हैं हॉस्पिटल से, वो गवर्नमेंट फंडेड होनी चाहिए या इंडिविजुअल को उसके लिए खुद पे करना चाहिए? आपको बताना है कि आप क्या सोचते हैं इस बारे में। नेक्स्ट, गवर्नमेंट स्पेंड अ लॉट ऑफ मनी ऑन पब्लिक सेलिब्रेशन सच एज नेशनल हॉलीडेज, पब्लिक फेस्टिवल्स। सम पीपल से दैट द गवर्नमेंट स्पेंड्स टू मच ऑन दिस एंड दे शुड यूज दिस मनी ऑन अदर यूजफुल थिंग्स। टू यू एग्री टू डिसएग्री? ऑलराइट, every country has got some national celebrations. It can be their independence day, their republic day, or day when they became independent, or they signed a constitution, or something that is very important to them. And this country spend lavish money on celebrating it every year. So a lot of people feel that the government spent massively, extensively on, lavishly on this. Rather, this money can be used in much, much better ways, like, you know, there are many problems in every country. So it can be, this money can be used in those areas. So you need to mention if you agree with this or you don't. All right, the next category is celebrities. I will say, like, this is new category for this year, and already questions have been asked in this category. These days, celebrities earn higher salary than senior politicians. What are the reasons for this? Is this negative, positive development for our country? All right. सवाल है कि आज का जो सेलिब्रिटीज है, राइट, सेलिब्रिटीज में प्लीज आप सिर्फ ये मत सोचिए कि हम हीरो हीरोइन से बात करेंगे, टॉकिंग अबाउट एक्टर्स और एक्ट्रेस। सो मेनी पीपल सेलिब्रिटी पीपल हु हैव बिकम फेमस राइट इन देयर ओन एरियाज आर रिगार्डेड एज सेलिब्रिटीज टू। दीज डेज लॉट ऑफ सेलिब्रिटीज बहुत ज्यादा पैसे कमा रहे हैं कंपेयर टू द सीनियर पॉलिटिशियंस। आपको ये बताना है किसी वजह क्या है और इसका कोई पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट होगा या नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट होगा कंट्री की डेवलपमेंट के ऊपर। द नेक्स्ट वन, nowadays celebrities are more famous for their glamour than, oh, it has been repeated, for their glamour. Or is it right, for their glamour and wealth than for their achievements, and this sets a bad example to the young people. To what extent do you agree or disagree? सो द क्वेश्चन इज, आजकल जो सेलिब्रिटीज है वो अपने ग्लैमर की वजह से, अपने वेल्थ की वजह से ज़्यादा चर्चा में रहते हैं, ज़्यादा फेमस है, रादर देन उनके अपनी अचीवमेंट्स और टैलेंट की वजह से। आपको बताना है इसका यंग जनरेशन पे क्या प्रभाव पड़ता है। नेक्स्ट, बींग अ सेलिब्रिटी सच एज फेमस फिल्म स्टार्स और स्पोर्ट्स पर्सनैलिटी ब्रिंग्स प्रॉब्लम्स एज वेल एज बेनिफिट्स। डू यू थिंक दैट बींग अ सेलिब्रिटी ब्रिंग्स मोर बेनिफिट्स और मोर प्रॉब्लम्स? Give reasons for your answer. Include any relevant examples from your own knowledge and experience. All right. The question says, these days, being a celebrity, right, or being a film star, being a sports star, have its own pros and cons, benefits, and it of course brings some issues with it. So you need to mention, are the benefits more or are the troubles more? And examiner asks you to give examples. So you need to mention any relevant example with this. Next, celebrity status no longer equates with talent, accomplishments, discuss. Okay, this is a very good question and deep in cover. The question states, celebrity status no longer equates with talent accomplishments. ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है कि ऐसे बंदे जिन्होंने कुछ अचीव कर लिया हो लाइफ के अंदर वही सेलिब्रिटी हैं। आजकल बहुत ऐसे लोग हैं, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल लाइक द किड्स ऑफ सेलिब्रिटीज हु हैव नॉट येट अचीव्ड एनीथिंग, दे स्टिल हैव द सेलिब्रिटी स्टेटस विद देम। सो यू नीड टू डिस्कस, यू नीड टू टॉक अबाउट दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स। लास्ट इन द सेलिब्रिटी सेक्शन, डू यू थिंक सेलिब्रिटीज हैव अ लाइफ That has more pros and less cons? आपको बताना कि सेलिब्रिटीज की जो लाइफ होती है उसके अंदर पॉजिटिव साइड ज़्यादा है या नेगेटिव साइड ज़्यादा है? ये इट्स सिमिलर टू द क्वेश्चन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट, यू नीड टू मैंशन द पॉइंट्स। मेक श्योर आप दो तीन पॉइंट्स को जरूर डिस्कस करिए एंड यू गिव रेलिवेंट एग्जाम्पल्स टू दिस। यू कैन टॉक अबाउट हॉलीवुड, लाइक यू नो एनी एरिया दैट यू नो यू कैन टॉक अबाउट दैट, स्पोर्ट्स एज वेल। नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी इज सोशल। Social is an important category, communication. People often do not interact with the neighbors and this is harming community building. What are the possible causes and solution? Okay, these days people are becoming recluse. They are becoming isolated. They don't like talking with others. So a lot of people don't talk to their neighbors. And this is harming the community building. So there's no harmony, like, you know, there's no community because people are not talking among themselves. So you need to mention what are the causes of this and what can be the possible solutions. Next question is, these days mobile phones and the internet are very important to the ways in which people relate to one another socially. Do the advantage of this development outweigh the disadvantages? That's a great question. The question is, these days people connect with each other using the mobile phone and the internet. It's just not like the old days. to connect socially, you need to talk about this. Basically, the way they connect to each other is like having more advantages or having disadvantages. Next, spoken communication is more powerful than written communication. Do you agree or disagree? It's a very good question. Question small, but it has got a big meaning. The spoken communication has more power, right? More power than the written communication. Do you agree or disagree? See, in written communication, you're never there to express your emotions, your feelings. No one cannot understand or looking at your face what you want to say, but that can happen in spoken communication. So you need to mention this kind of things. Next, more and more individuals are choosing to communicate either professionally or socially using technology rather than face to face. Discuss the advantage and disadvantage of using technology for communication. See, if technology is having its own pro side, technology is also having lots of sides which is negative. For example, this question, these a lot of individuals are using the technology, right, to connect with each other professionally or socially using technology rather than face-to-face. People, they don't like meeting a lot of people face-to-face. They rather use technology, like, you know, they message each other or they connect through video conferencing. So you need to tell what is the impact of going to with this. What are the advantages and disadvantages of this thing? Next, some people think that being able to communicate with others online is breaking down geographical barriers. Okay, and enabling people who would never have the chance to meet to communicate. What are the advantages of international communication online? Are they interested? This is a good question. The question is, this is because of technology, you are able to meet and talk to the people who are far away geographically. For example, you are in one country in the east side and you're talking to some person who's far away, far away in the west, and you're able to talk to them. It's just because of the technology. So you need to tell what are the advantages of international communication. Does it bring any kind of advantage at all, or are there only disadvantages to this? You need to discuss that thing. Next question is about education. Many students take part-time jobs while studying in the university. Is this a good or bad thing? I would say it's a good thing, but you need to talk about yourself. Like, a lot of students, bahut sare bachche hain jo university mein kaam karte hue, say like wo part-time job karna prefer karte hain. Aapko batate hain iska kya prabhav padta hai unke upar, ye achhi cheez hai ya buri cheez hai. Next, some people believe that music should be taught in school, while others think that it is the best to focus on computer and science. Do you agree or disagree? Lots of people believe that music should be taught in school, कि उन्हें एक रेगुलर स्टडी से ब्रेक मिलता है, राइट, कि हम म्यूजिक को सिखाना चाहिए बच्चों को. पर कुछ लोगों का ये मानना है कि नहीं, उन्हें सिर्फ कंप्यूटर्स और साइंस जैसी चीज़ सिखानी चाहिए, बिकॉज सब्जेक्ट्स लाइक कंप्यूटर एंड साइंस आर गोइंग टू हेल्प देम अ लॉट इन द फ्यूचर एंड वुड हेल्प देम मेक अ गुड करियर. यू नीड टू टॉक अबाउट, डू यू एग्री टू दिस और यू डोंट एग्री टू दिस. नेक्स्ट, यूनिवर्सिटीज शुड एलोकेट द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ मनी टू स्टूडेंट्स स्पोर्ट्स एक्टिविटीज एज दे एलोकेट टू देयर लाइब्रेरीज. ओके, universities jitna paisa, you know, jitna the kind of money they give to the sports, they should invest the same kind of money in their libraries as well. That, like, it's a huge resource. Next, many people say that the only way to guarantee a good job is to complete a course of university education. Others claim that it is better to start after school and gain experience in the world of work. Discuss. Many people say that if you complete your university education, you can have sure shot a good job. But some people feel that it's important to complete the university education, and you can only after that you can get a good job. Some people believe that education is the key to tackling hunger worldwide, while others feel that the answer is in food aid. Okay, some people believe that education solves the crisis of food which is being faced worldwide, but some people believe is actually the food aid that you can provide and solve the hunger. See, both has got its own side. You need to talk about it very wisely. Some people believe that education is the some people believe that universities should only accept students with the highest marks, while others believe that some students with low marks should have an opportunity. Discuss both sides. Okay, it's saying that universities should only accept students with good grades, high grades, whereas some people believe that universities should also accept the students which are having low grades so that they can have some sort of opportunity. Now it can happen, some person is coming from he has been deprived of the facilities that he could have and he could have actually scored good. So they should keep in consideration. Next is about tourism. Nowadays, international tourism is the biggest industry in the world. Unfortunately, international tourism creates tension rather than understanding between people from different cultures. To what extent do you agree or disagree with this opinion? The question is saying international tourism is becoming one of the biggest industries in this world. Actually, a lot of people are traveling these days, so it does create a lot of revenue. Unfortunately, international tourism creates tension rather than understanding between people from different culture. So now it's a big barrier. Now if you are from different culture and you're going into a different culture, there may be a lot of misunderstandings in the way you behave over there, because you cannot possibly know all the rules of that particular country or that particular community, and it can at times create a lot of hurdles. So this is what the question is saying. To what extent do you agree or disagree with this opinion? So do you agree with this notion? If yes, you need to mention why, or if you are against, then vice versa. As international travel is becoming cheaper, more and more countries are allowing in more tourists. Do the advantage of this outweigh the disadvantage, right? As international travel is becoming cheaper, lot of countries are allowing people to come into their countries and visit them. And more tourists are going towards those places. For example, I'll quote Bhutan. These days, lots of people are traveling to Bhutan. It is it's the only carbon neutral country in the world. And very beautiful. So you need to mention, do the advantages outweigh the disadvantages or not? Next question is, international tourism has brought enormous benefit to many places. At the same time, there is concern about its impact on local inhabitants and the environment. Do the disadvantages of international tourism outweigh the advantages? Give reasons for your answer and include any relevant examples from your knowledge or experience. All right, the statement might be big, but the question is very simple. The question is, international tourism has brought many benefits to many places in the world, right? And at the same time, there's concern about the impact on local inhabitants and the environment with that one. Okay, like I mentioned, the cheaper travel, there are a lot of factors, people are traveling these days, so it is bringing in a lot of revenue. But simultaneously, when a lot of people are going to a small community, it can have its own impacts and negative ones. So you need to mention it, actually, does it outweigh the advantages or does not? Tourism has become a major source of income for all countries. Right, the advantages and disadvantages of tourism, what should be done to ensure healthy tourism? Okay. Yes, it is a fact that tourism has become a main source of income to many countries. For example, if I talk about Nepal, right? Nepal, a lot of people visit Nepal. It's a small country and tourism brings in a lot of revenue. So it's basically talking about countries like this. So you need to mention, is it a healthy tourism or not? Organized tours to remote community and other countries are increasingly popular. Is it a positive or negative development for local people and the local environment? Okay, this is people, what they're planning is there is a new trend. No, people are going to far away places which are not feasible. So there are a lot of companies which are providing organized tours. So people get into groups and go to this places. So you need to mention, is it a positive development or a negative development? You have to mention your own viewpoints. Tourism is becoming increasingly important as a source of revenue to many countries, but its disadvantage should not be overlooked. I've already mentioned there can be few disadvantages to this, like people keep on traveling to one small place or secluded location, and they can actually hamper the sanctity of that place. For example, if some place is meant for some place was hidden as a treasure, its natural beauty, lots of people start traveling over there, so slowly things become commercialized over there, so it can have its own negative impacts. Some people think that foreign visitors should be charged more than locals when they visit cultural and tourist attractions in a country. To what extent do you agree with this view? Okay, some people have this belief that if some foreign nationals are coming to a country to visit places that hold some historical or cultural importance, then they should be charged more. So you need to mention, do you agree with this thing or not? In some places it happens, like once I visited Nepal, so it so happened that I had to pay more as a international traveler, then the people or their local had to pay for the same thing to visit. It was basically a temple, entrance to a temple. Next category is science. Scientists believe that in order to protect the environment, people must use less energy in their daily lives. However, most people have not changed the way they live. Why do you think many people have not taken individual action? What could be done to encourage them to take action? All right, scientists believe that if you want to protect the environment, we need to use less energy in their daily lives. In our daily lives, less energy, and this energy can be in the form of, say, like the ones which we generate from the fossil fuels, from or it can be from, it cannot be clean energy which we are talking about. So they're saying, and we need to alter the way we live. So it means we need to be more dependent on things that comes from clean energy. What could be done to encourage, like we can promote solar panels. There's so many ways which we are, like windmill energy coming from windmill, and there's so many other things. Science will soon make people live up to 100 or even 200 years. Some believe that is a good thing, while others disagree. Discuss both views and give your opinion. All right. There's lots of advancement going in science these days, and like initially, if we talk about decades back, people did not used to live by the age of 70, 80, as we are living now. And as science is advancing, it's quite possible that later people might live up to the age of 100 or 150, 200. So you need to mention, is this good or some people say that it's a good thing. Some people are saying that it's a good thing because you'll be able to live with your relatives, a big family, lots of friends, and you can live together in Cholo movies. While some people disagree with this because, of course, you will be consuming a lot of resources. There will be a big population. Discuss both views and give your opinion. You need to discuss both sides, and you need to mention your opinion on this. Scientists and technology experts seem to be more valued by modern society than musicians and arts. To what extent do you agree? All right, these days scientists and technologies or people, technology experts, they're more valued because maybe probably because everything that we do is dependent to technology right now, rather than musician and artist, they're not valued that much. So do you agree with this? First thing is that if at all you agree, you need to mention why. In today's world of advanced science and technology, we still greatly value what artists such as musicians, painters, and writers. What can art tell us about life that science and technology cannot? All right, it's a very good question. It has appeared before also. We might have some very great scientists, doctors, technology people, experts living with us, but we cannot ignore the people coming from art, like musicians, actors, because they tell us about emotions. They tell us about a part of, history that we have lived in. And music, of course, it helps in cutting down our stress, or every person has got their own reason. So you need to mention what art can tell us about life that science and technology cannot. So like one thing is, of course, it cannot tell us about emotions, which I feel but you're free to tell your own viewpoint. Some people say that it is necessary to use animals for testing the medicines intended for human beings. Others, however, think it is cruel and unnecessary. Discuss both views and give your opinion. This is a very good question. So lots of people believe that no medicines which are made for human being, they should be first tested on animals. So you need to tell, and some people believe it is totally cruel and unnecessary. So you need to discuss both sides and give your own opinions. All right. The next category to this is environment. It's a very important category. Environmental issues have always been an international problem because governments are not imposing harsh punishment against offenders. To what extent do you agree or disagree? Support your answer with specific reasons and examples. Okay, environmental issues are the biggest issue because the basic thing, like the oxygen we need to breathe in, if there's no oxygen, you cannot breathe. So probably environmental crisis should be our topmost priority right now. Question says, environmental issues have always been an international problem because governments are not imposing harsh punishment against offenders. एनवायरमेंट की जो प्रॉब्लम हमारे लिए सबसे ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट होनी चाहिए. सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम यह है कि गवर्नमेंट जो है बहुत ज़्यादा पेनल्टी नहीं लगा रही उन लोगों के खिलाफ जो एनवायरमेंट के से लाइक एनवायरमेंट को हैम्पर कर रहे हैं. लाइक द वेस्ट कमिंग फ्रॉम इंडस्ट्रीज, लोग उसे सीधा दे डंप इट इन द वाटर, लोग उसे पानी में सीधा डंप कर देते हैं, कॉजिंग मोर वाटर पोल्यूशन. सो आप इस पर किस हद तक सहमत हैं? यू नीड टू गिव ओन आंसर्स एंड एग्जाम्पल्स. Many efforts have been made by countries to address challenges concerning the environment, but the situation has not improved. Okay, what are the possible reasons for environmental degradation? Are there any solutions to combat this problem? Support your answer with specific reasons and examples. Okay, many countries are doing lots of efforts, whatever they can, to contain this environment problem as it's escalating day by day. Din ba din ye problem badh rahi hai. Har country apni shamta ke andar jo kiya ja sakta kar rahi hai. फिर भी ये सिचुएशन नहीं सुधरी है. आपको बताना है कि क्या वजह है कि एनवायरनमेंट डिग्रेड होता जा रहा है, एनवायरनमेंट दूषित होता जा रहा है. आर देयर एनी सॉल्यूशंस टू कॉम्बैट दिस प्रॉब्लम? क्या कोई सॉल्यूशन है भी इस चीज़ को सॉल्व करने का? आर देयर एनी सॉल्यूशंस एट ऑल विच यूजिंग विच वी कैन सॉल्व दिस एनवायरमेंटल क्राइसिस? सपोर्ट योर आंसर्स. राइट, एनवायरमेंटल प्रॉब्लम्स सच एज पोल्यूशन एंड क्लाइमेट वेरिएशंस आर इंक्रीजिंग नाउडेज. द गवर्नमेंट हैज टेकन मेजर ग्लोबल लेवल बट दे आर got only few solution. Okay, the environmental pollution, like, you know, the variation, environmental pollution and the variation climate is increasing day by day. The government has taken lots of steps. Kuch solutions bhi mile hain but itne nahi. Aapko batana hai kaisa kyun ho raha hai aur kya kiya ja sakta hai. Despite clear warnings from climate scientists, few people are changing their habits. Why is this the case? What can be done to encourage people to protect the environment? The environmentalist scientists have told us that we are at a huge crisis stage right now. Hum bahut zyada crisis se guzar rahe hain environment ki. Fir bhi kai log apne habit nahi badal rahe hain. People are depending too much on the plastic. They create a lot of waste using fossil fuels. What can be done to encourage people to protect the environment? हम क्या कर सकते हैं कि लोगों को और ज़्यादा प्रोत्साहित करें कि वो environmental problem को solve करें? Some people think that one of the best ways to solve environmental problems is to increase the cost of fuel for cars and other vehicles. To what extent do you agree with this? कुछ लोगों का मानना है कि अगर हम actually में fuel की cost ही बढ़ा दें जो लोग use करते हैं cars में, जैसे petrol, diesel, you know, they can increase the cost of this. So people, they think the environmental problem would be solved to a greater extent. What do you think about it? You need to mention that. क्या ये सही है या नहीं है? I guess probably sports will be the last category. In order to be successful at a sport, some think you must be physically strong while others believe mental strength is more important. Discuss both views and give your opinion. कुछ लोगों का मानना है कि sports में success हासिल करने के लिए आपको mentally fit होना चाहिए rather than physically fit, because as they say, if you accept you're defeated, but if you keep on fighting, you don't let your mind accept it, you keep on going. आपको यही बताना कि physical fitness आपकी ज़्यादा matter करती है या mental fitness. Many companies sponsor sports as a way of advertising themselves. Some people think that it is a good thing, while others think that it has disadvantages. Discuss both views. कई कंपनियाँ अपने आप को promote करने के लिए sports का सहारा लेती हैं, तो वो sports event को sponsor करती हैं. कई लोग का मानना है कि बिल्कुल सही चीज़ है, अच्छा प्लेटफॉर्म है. कई लोग का मानना है कि नहीं, इट हैज़ इट्स ओन डिसएडवांटेजेस, इसकी अपनी कमियां हैं. आपको दोनों बारे में बताना है. नाउडेज एडल्ट्स डू लिटिल एक्सरसाइज. सम पीपल बिलीव दैट द बेस्ट वे टू एड्रेस दिस इशू इज बाय कवरिंग ग्रेट स्पोर्ट्स इवेंट्स सच एज ओलंपिक ऑन टेलीविजन. अदर्स थिंक दैट इज मोर बेनिफिशियल टू टेक अदर मेजर्स. व्हाई दिस Nowadays, adults do little exercise. Some people believe that the best way to get at the issue is by covering. Okay, कई आजकल जो say like the people who are young adults, right? I'll say even for the kids, we people are not exercising anymore. We are living a very inactive lifestyle. So some people believe that's important that we go cover events such as the Olympics and sports, and we actually start copying them. We start doing those kind of things, so it can bring a change to us. Others think that it is more beneficial to take other measures. It can be other activities as well, like yoga or something. What is your opinion? You have to mention about it. Many famous sports players advertise sports products. Do the advantages of this outweigh the disadvantages? आजकल बहुत सारे स्पोर्ट्स प्लेयर्स हैं जो say like sports products को sponsor करते हैं. आपको बताना है कि क्या इसके एडवांटेजेस ज़्यादा है या इसके डिसएडवांटेज ज़्यादा है. पॉपुलर इवेंट्स लाइक द फुटबॉल वर्ल्ड कप एंड अदर इंटरनेशनल स्पोर्टिंग ओकेशंस आर असेंशियल इन ईजिंग इंटरनेशनल टेंशंस एंड रिलीजिंग पेट्रियोटिक इमोशंस इन अ सेफ वे. ओके, पॉपुलर इवेंट्स जैसे फुटबॉल वर्ल्ड कप हो गया, क्रिकेट वर्ल्ड कप हो गया, ये ऐसे ओकेशंस होते हैं जहाँ पे इंटरनेशनल टेंशन को कम किया जाता है और हमारा एक्चुअली पेट्रियाटिज्म बाहर निकल के आता है बहुत सेफ वे के अंदर, बिकॉज वी बिलीव स्पोर्ट्स इज अ वेरी हेल्थी थिंग. सो यू नीड टू मेंशन इज इट ट्रू और नॉट. सो लाइक देयर मेनी इवेंट्स स्पोर्ट्स लाइक लॉट ऑफ पीपल फ्रॉम टू डिफरेंट कंट्रीज सिटिंग टुगेदर इन वन स्टेडियम, दे शो अ लॉट ऑफ लव टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर कंट्री, टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर प्लेयर्स. Like many countries, people from South Africa have huge respect towards the people from Australia, people from India has huge respect for people from South Africa, so it's vice versa, you know. And countries like in India, Pakistan, we all love each other, the players, we love different players. So these platforms are good for releasing those kind of tension, showing our patriotism. So friend, this was the thing about the essay part. I think probably discuss all the essay categories which are important considering the January to April 2020 session. And it's not that it's only confined to January to April. It can, these questions can come throughout the year. So if you like this video, click like, share with your friends. And those who have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel. A small thing, I've started writing collection services. People who are employed and cannot go to the IELTS institutes and get the writing check, they can scan their copies. Please make sure you write with a pencil. Scan your copies. Send it to IELTSWITHARUN@gmail.com. IELTSWITHARUN@gmail.com. Please send it to me, mention it in a subject. I'll try my best to check and send it to you as soon as possible. Till then, thank you so much for watching the video and have a great day ahead and all the best for your examination.